Let's say you want to make a mask for yourself at home. Not all masks are created equal. In a way, it's all about percentages. Cloth masks are intended mostly to protect other people from droplets you might exhale. Cloth masks do a good job at keeping in large respiratory droplets, you know, the kind you spit out when coughing or talking. But there's another possible benefit to wearing a mask, protecting yourself from droplets. And homemade masks will vary in how good they are at keeping out germs. SARS-CoV-2 is a normal-sized virus, approximately 120 nanometers in diameter, or roughly 10,000 times smaller than the head of a pin. Some fabrics are better than others at blocking out particles in that size range. For example, a single-layer mask made from a top-of-the-line 400-thread-count pillowcase might have a filtration efficiency of around 10% of small particles in the range of 300 nanometers. That's the size used to test N95 respirators. Meanwhile, N95 respirators filter out at least 95% of small particles in this range when worn properly. Of course, they really need to be reserved for healthcare workers. A homemade mask is going to be somewhere in between. If you're looking to boost your mask's ability to filter out small particles, I've got 3 tips from researchers who've been studying homemade mask materials in light of the pandemic. This tip comes from Dr. Scott Siegel of Wake Forest School of Medicine. He's been putting various cloth mask materials to the test since March. His rule of thumb, hold up the fabric to a bright light or to the sun. If you can see the light outlining the individual fibers in the fabric, it's probably not a good filter. And if you can't see the light so easily through the fabric, it's probably going to make a better filter. Choose a thicker fabric with a tighter weave. Just make sure it's not so thick that you can't breathe through it. This tip comes from Yang Wang of Missouri University of Science and Technology. He studies how fine particles like aerosols are transmitted. Back to that pillowcase. Wang found that one layer of a 400 thread count pillowcase filters out 10% of small particles, but 4 layers, 20%. The point is, you're going to want to ensure your mask has layers or even a pocket for removable filters or a thick cotton layer sewn into the mask itself. This is why many do-it-yourself mask patterns recommend folding the material over at least one time. Researcher Loretta Fernandez of Northeastern University has found that adding an outer layer of nylon stocking to a homemade mask can boost its ability to filter out fine particles. That's because that outer layer of nylon creates a tighter seal between the mask and your face. Her research found that this can boost a mask's ability to keep out small particles by as much as 50%. Tights should also work as long as they offer a snug fit. Experts say masks alone aren't enough to manage the transmission of the coronavirus. But when you couple it with other strategies like social distancing, testing, and good hand hygiene, masks can play a role in keeping transmission of the virus at a low level. So suit up and stay safe. Thanks.